And the beginning of Past Moriah was there were a lot of. It seems as though your theatrical history has a lot to do with a lot of really interesting experimental pieces. Pieces yeah. that is that something that. sorry, excuse me. Is that something that you sought out, or is that something that
no,
just happened to you?
No, no. Like I said, that was. They asked me just. Mm-hmm. Asked me. People must have seen stuff I'd done and whatnot. And they asked me.
And you know, the Shakespeare's and the and stuff like that. I mean, did you ever feel like you should have had a career at Stratford or done, you know?
Well, I auditioned for them a couple of times. And the experience wasn't good. And then in terms of, I remember one particular one with Robin Phillips. I thought he was just, he showed no interest. I thought he was very rude. Who needs this?
Mm-hmm. Right.
I don't know if I'm allowed expletives on this.
I don't know. Can we use? Okay.
One of my tenets. I say that this in life all the time. Mm-hmm. I don't know if you ever heard me say it. Oh, f*** them if they can't take a joke.
Right.
You know, so that was, I said, well, I can take a joke. If he, that's the way he's behaving, I can take a joke. Because I would say, f*** them if they can't take a joke.
Right.
So I, okay, so that's what I said. F*** them if they can't, and never.
Yeah, never worried about it.
No.
Huh. Tell me about August Schellenberg.
Oh, Augie's my dear friend. Augie, I met at theater school my first year. And he was third year. And he was, Blevis is another very good friend. So he was Blevis, Blendick, James Blendick, Mary, Donnie Allison, Anne, Anglin.
Right, Anne Anglin.
Yeah. Those guys were in the third year.
Oh, right.
So I got in there and Augie, you know, he'd talk and ask me about music and drumming and so on. He's a very good drummer. He's I can't drum. And we just got on very well. And, you know, they'd have a beer and so on, and he'd invite me. You know, and you know what? He used to call me an Indian. I'm West
what?
Indian.
Oh, right. Okay.
So then he'd shorten it and say, you Indian.
Right.
Okay, it was lots of fun, yeah. Huh. I still see him. I got an email from him just a couple of days ago. I sent one, actually, mentioning that Len Donchef had passed. So see him and Joni. They're in Texas. My daughter lives in Texas, so when I go down, I'd see them.
He's in Texas?
What's he left a long time.
Really?
Oh, okay. When, when I moved into... Yeah, PAL in 93. Augie and Joan bought me some bread and salt and wine.
That's really
and,
nice.
And after that, they moved to Texas. I think they had done, Free Willy had done a lot of selling of the cassettes and tapes and so on. And the producers were very good to them.
Right.
So I think he was able to move to the States. And of course, he's won. First Nations Best Actor Award a few times, right? And he was up for the genies and stuff. I've worked with a lot of people. I mean, like stage, even film. I've checked. I've worked with about 7-8 Oscar winners. I mean, appeared with them.
Who? Name some.
Daniel Petrie.
Daniel Petrie. What was that like?
Oh, he was sweet. He was very nice. Knew what he wanted. And Morgan Freeman.
Okay.
On the same piece.
On the same piece. So what was the piece?
This one was the execution of Raymond Graham.
Okay.
It was the anniversary of one of the networks, ABC, I think. So they went back to the beginnings of television when everything was live and you'd see people walking through sets, flats falling over and stuff,
right?
So Petrie coming from that background, was asked to do the piece. Mm-hmm. So it was done in Toronto with a hookup, live hookup in New York, Chicago, and LA. So everybody came here. Parts of it was done pre-taped in Kingston. It was about someone who was being executed by lethal injection.
Oh, I see.
And okay. It was timed.
Right.
So the clock you're looking at is real time.
Ah, wow.
So it had to be rehearsed and everything set and taped twice before.
Hmm.
So that in case there was a breakdown between
the
coast of the continent,
it could still go.
Yes.
Oh, okay. Wow.
So that was it. I remember I'm sitting there and this guy comes in, that guy comes in a cowboy hat and a suede jacket and so on. He comes and he sits down after me. How are you doing? Okay, I'm Ardon Bess. I'm Morgan. So. Say hi. Recognize you, I know you, don't you? You say, yeah, well, you will certainly will know me. Morgan was, he was so thorough, you know, he had this cool, but he's a nice man too. Again, I remember one night we're hanging out himself and George Zunder. He asked me to, you know, having coffee. And they were talking about weight and losing weight.
Morgan Freeman's talking about losing weight.
Yeah, he had done a film where he played a pimp.
Okay.
And he was skinny as a rake.
Right.
And Zunder was talking about running and running. During the time we were doing the rehearsing, he would find time to run.
Mm-hmm.
And Morgan said, well, before I go, do a shoot, I'd lose 10 pounds. Three days before, start 3 days and I'd lose 10 pounds. So I said, 10 pounds? How do you do that? He said, just don't eat, that's all. Just don't eat.
Just don't eat, really?
And all he was drinking during that time was coffee.
Really?
Yes, that's his way of doing it.
That can't be healthy.
No, that's what I thought.
That's what he did.
I thought, yeah.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm.